click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, I welcome you all to this video. We are with chapter 5 of digital image processing, where we have the image enhancement techniques made possible while working into the frequency domain. We started this chapter to know what exactly the mathematical tool Fourier transform is, along with the knowledge of frequency domain, how the sampling of the data can be there into the frequency domain, and how the reconstruction of the information from the sampled version of information is possible. That also we are dealt with. We started to see the image enhancement while working into the frequency domain using the low pass type of filter, and now the high pass type of filter. For low pass, we have the ideal type, Gaussian type, Butterworth type. For high pass, we have also dealt with the ideal, and now we are going to see the Gaussian type. So let us have a simple MATLAB demonstration for the same. So here we are provided with the MATLAB environment, and in this MATLAB environment we shall be having the script here for MATLAB programming purpose. So let us take a new script. So very first line, I shall be commenting the objective that we shall be accomplishing in this particular video. So here I mark a comment here. So this is a program for Gaussian type of high pass filtering. So we begin with, first of all, CLC, then clear all, close all. Now we require an image so that we can perform this type of the filtering. So if you check the current folder here, we have several of the images: autumn.tif, the babyelephant.jpg, the baby in cradle png, like this lena.jpg, mina.jpg. So from these images we shall be taking one as the input. So here I shall be taking a variable im that will hold this input image, and for getting the image into the MATLAB environment we shall be making the use of the MATLAB syntax imread. So with imread, a pair of parentheses and a pair of single quotes, I shall be mentioning the name of the image that is available into the current folder. So this image, we select the very popular, that it is cameraman.tif. We have this particular image read into the MATLAB environment. I will like to first of all save this program and execute this much. So I save this with the name. So this time we give program2 as the name, .m will be the file extension. So see here, it has been generated into the current folder, as well as the name is also changed onto this tab here. So when we run this particular program, we see here into the workspace that it was empty. The variable name im has been generated here. The dimensions are 256 by 256 with the type uint8 here. So further, we shall be making the use of another variable that will be actually the cutoff frequency value here. So we make 100 as the assignment to the variable fc here. Next to that, as our chapter is titled image enhancement into the frequency domain, so get shifted our image representation into the frequency domain, we shall be making the use of Fourier transform. So to hold the information of the image represented in frequency domain, we make a variable. So that variable we name imf here, and now we perform the syntax that it is FFT shift here over the Fourier transform of, so it will be FFT2, and the input will be the input image variable im. So we terminate the line with semicolon here, and now for further programming purpose we will like to have two dimensions. The dimensions as like I mark CO and RO here. So the CO and RO are assigned the values with the syntax size here, and the size is of the input image holded by im variable. So after the size variable that we have here, so now we shall be proceeding further to find cx is equal to, here we make round and we get co divided by 2 here. Whereas similar operation we can perform, so that we can make computation of cy is equal to round, and this will be for ro divided by 2 here. So we also terminate this with the semicolon. Further, we make the computation of the variable capital H. So capital H, we assign a matrix of zeros, hence the syntax is zeros, whereas the dimension size, that it is nothing but CO comma RO here. Now we shall be making use of the for loop here. So we start with for loop with the index variable I that hold the values 1 to CO. So in this for loop we shall be having the assignment of another for loop with another index variable, that it is j, and it holds the values 1 up to RO here. Now we have the nested for loops one inside another. So now we compute a variable d, so that it is equal to, we have the I variable minus the cx that we have computed, and to this particular bracket we give the power 2 here. Now we add this particular bracket with another bracket that has j minus cy, and this bracket is also having the power 2. So after the computation of small d as like this, we make capital H that has the two variables we have used in this for loop, the index terms I comma j. So these can be computed by exponential of, here we operate for minus d divided by 2 by the cutoff frequency fc by fc again we can make. And finally we can make ending to both of these for loops here. Next to that, we shall be making h is equal to 1 minus capital H, and finally the variable out f can be computed here by element to element multiplication of, here we have imf variable that has holded the Fourier transform information of the original image with the variable capital H just now computed into the above step here. So after this particular step, now it is time to make execution whether the out f has been generated or not. So this way we have the Gaussian type of high pass filtering. So let us save the changes into the script here and also run the program here. So in the workspace, in the family of various variables, we have the variable outf. So outf has the dimensions 256 by 256, whereas the representation type is of complex double. So it means that we are still into the frequency domain, and for the display purpose of whatever the filtering we have done onto the input image, we need to get back to the spatial domain. So for that purpose, we shall be making the use of inverse Fourier transform. Therefore, we write here the variable out computed as making the absolute of, and here we shall be applying the inverse Fourier transform. So it is I FFT2, and this is operated over the variable out f. So this will give us back to the spatial domain. And now the last thing is to make a display of whatever the changes we have made for Gaussian type of high pass filtering on input images. So for that purpose, I write here I am show, and the very first of all we shall be displaying the input image. So I provide it input im variable. We can make assignment of title to this particular display window, and here the title will be within the parenthesis and a pair of single quotes here. We shall writing here original image here. By the next line we shall be having the keyword figure, so that a separate window for display purpose will be generated here. And after the figure we shall be making the use of again im show, and this time we shall be providing it the input that it is the variable out. After this assignment we shall be providing a title, and the title here will be the filtered image. So this is the image that has been filtered for Gaussian type of high pass filtering. Next to that we can make the use of again figure, then we shall be making the use of im show. This time we shall be displaying the filter function represented by the variable h here. And now the title to this display of the image section here will be a two-dimensional view of, so it should be in a pair of single quotes, 2D view of. Here we have the filter function represented capital H. At last we again make the use of figure keyword here, and we shall be making the use of three-dimensional display. So for that purpose I use the command here surf serp here, applicable to the input filter function variable capital H. And next to that we can assign the title here. So the title here we assign a 3D view of H. So this completes our program script. We save all the script with the name program2.m here, and let us run this particular program. So as we run this particular program, we have obtained the four figures here. So this is the figure one that I maximize. This is the original image, cameraman.tif, you can visualize in the original form. Next to that we have figure 2 displayed here. So this is nothing but the filtered image. So after application of the filter while working into the frequency domain, we obtain such an image by Gaussian type of high pass filtering. This is the third image where we see the two-dimensional view of the function capital H. And lastly we have the fourth window to display us the three-dimensional view of capital H. So here you can see the zoomed version here, or we can get it to the restored view also. So this is the three-dimensional view of the filter function. So I hope this simple MATLAB demonstration has definitely benefited you to make a practice of digital image processing into the MATLAB environment. By the next lecture, we shall be continuing with high pass filtering for the Butterworth type here. I hope you enjoy the digital image processing as well the theory and the practicals we share with you people. For more information and the knowledge of this subject, you can subscribe to eKida channel. Thank you.